Hi everyone, it's Char. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. Today I'm doing such a fun video because I'm showing you all of my prettiest books, my prized bookish possessions. This is admittedly a pretty self-indulgent video, but I personally think all of these books are beautiful. I see them as artwork on my shelves, but of course many of them are also books that I absolutely adore with my whole heart. I also just love watching videos of people's special edition books, so I wanted to do one of my own. So without further ado, I'm going to show you some of the most beautiful books on my bookshelves, and let's have a relaxing 15 minutes or so together. So the first book I got from Era Books, and this is Ice Planet Barbarians book one. I read IPB a couple of years ago and I really loved it, which is a surprise to no one. I love monster romance, alien romance, sci-fi romance. This is a sci-fi romance. I'm not gonna give you the summary for each book because that just sounds annoying, and your girl is moving. She's very busy. But this is just a book that I think is quite beautiful. Here are the end pages. It's like little spaceships and mountains, and I think the arrows for the ice planet barbarians on Not Hoth, as they call it. And that is just what it looks like. Of course, my favorite aspect of this book, realizing I probably should not film this in cinematic mode. Let's switch modes together. We'll just do a beautiful normal video so that you can actually see the edges. It has the little spaceships and the mountains, and I just think it is such a beautiful book with the little stars and like the little galaxy bits here. She's gorgeous. She's beautiful. I love her. The next book is admittedly a simpler edition, but this is a cover of Entreat Me that only exists within this special edition of it. It has all of this gorgeous gold foiling, which is so lovely and shiny, and there are hidden elements of the story within the cover itself. For example, the roses, and just like visualizing the characters who are so beautifully drawn. Like, they are quite honestly stunning. And this is what the edges looked like. I don't know what this is called, so if you know what that's called, let me know. This isn't like a stencil or anything. It literally is 3D. It's reflective. It's shiny. It's kind of like foiling, which I really love. Then we have the back pages where you see the castle, because this is a Beauty and the Beast retelling. Here is our hero, and here he is. And his beast form, so quite scary. I absolutely adore this edition of the book. This is what the end papers look like. Again, you have the castle, more of the roses and the vines. The roses are, and the thorns of the roses, are a very ominous presence throughout the story. This is, again, just a gorgeous edition that I really love, and I also just really love this book. Next book is not necessarily a special edition, but it is a limited edition, because this is the first run print of A Dowry of Blood when it was indie published by S.T. Gibson. You cannot get your hands on this anymore. It got picked up. It was traditionally published. So it's not rare, but more, you just can't buy this like in stores. You would have to find someone selling it, and they usually resell it for really ridiculous prices. I do own a special edition of this book that is a Fairy Loot edition, but I just happen to like this more. I like this cover a lot more. I think it is so much fun. I love that how far from far away, to me, it looks like a skeleton, but if I bring it all the way in, you can see that it's actually a woman. And I just think this cover is quite pretty. I also just adore this book, and it's a prized possession for me because it's the indie published version of A Dowry of Blood. This book completely took me by surprise this year, and it's Fangirl Down by Tessa Bailey. If you watch my sports romance reading vlog, you'll know that I read this and was shockingly completely obsessed with it and gave it almost 5 stars. Immediately ordered a special edition of it. I'm forgetting where I ordered this from, but I know that it was only $15 with free shipping. This is what the edges look like. It says Wells Bell. This is a golf romance. That is what she calls her herself as his biggest fan, because Fangirl Down, she is his fangirl. The edges go all the way around. I don't know what that pattern is called, but it's like what you see in like golf shirts and things like that. This is what the inside looks like. So the end papers, I will tell you, the dust jacket's not reversible, just so you know that, but the book has the same pattern in its naked hardcover, which I love when the naked hardcover also has a design. The end papers are so pretty. That is Josephine, and I already forgot this man's name, but that's them in their relationship. You see that she has a poster of him hung up, and this is a very important scene in the book. I won't tell you which scene, but it is an important scene in the book. And that's another super important scene in the book. I won't spoil it for you, but it is just so beautifully drawn and illustrated. The end papers are absolutely stunning. The book is beautiful, and she was so inexpensive for what she is. All right, we have Emily Wilde's Encyclopedia of Fairies. One, adored this book. This was one of my favorite books of last year. I gave it 5 stars. I think it is so much fun. It is so cozy. It is so dark and scary, but also just so much fun to read. Well, there are scary moments in terms of the lore. It's not a scary book, but I love the kind of reflectiveness of the purple mushrooms and grapes on this cover. This is from Fairy Loot. This is what the back looks like with even more beautiful decorative details. The dust jacket is not reversible, but I've already mentioned I love when the naked hardcover is also beautiful. And beautiful she is. We have the beautiful gold shiny element, a bit of a darker version of it with the purple. It is just so lovely and so gorgeous with the gold flowers and the trees and branches and stuff. Here are the end papers. We have Emily and I always call him Bramblebee, something like that. That's them here. And we have the end pages of them again doing their research in the little cozy element. And then we have this just gorgeous, like grapes and mushrooms and leaves and just things like that and the stencils. It does not go all the way around. It is just on the edges and the rest of the book is just purple sprayed edges. I love this, and I did order the sequel to this, also the Fairy Loot edition of it, so I could have a matching set. Now those are the special edition books that I've read, loved, and just happened to own special editions of. Some I did purposely seek out. Some I got in book subscriptions and happened to really love them. The rest of these I got in book subscription boxes. And full disclaimer, I canceled all of my subscriptions a really long time ago. The only subscription that I currently have is Afterlight, and that's because I wanted the June book for it. I will cancel it after that. I have a lot of thoughts on these kind of subscriptions, but I still want to show you the books that I own that I think are quite beautiful. So we have Spells for Forgetting by Adrienne Young. This has a really strong mystery element to it, so I think that when I do read this, I am really going to love it. I just think that the sprayed edges on this are really, really gorgeous and just well done. You can see the forest, the trees, the kind of mist rolling over the forest within it, as well as the sparks of light. Here is a clearer view of the forest within the sprayed edges. I do spray my own edges at times, so I know how difficult like this kind of thing can be if you're spraying it yourself. Then we have absolutely stunning end paper here. Like, that is so, so, so pretty. What a beautiful scene. The moon is so glowing in this one. And then we have the back end pages, which I love when it looks like it's the same scene from different perspectives. This is obviously a different night because the moon is full on this one. So it's absolutely stunning. And then of course we have the naked cover with all of this gold foiling, Spells for Forgetting across the side, and the back is just a plain like emerald green color. This book is the only one I have like it, and that is because it is Starling House by Alex E. Harrow, and it is the only special edition book that I have with a clear dust jacket. So it looks like this. It's very shiny. I think these are ravens or crows. I don't fucking know bird species. It's one of them. In the front, starlings. Are they starlings? They must be starlings. On the front, with all of these beautiful colors, like you can't see it super clearly, but the coloring of the birds is so pretty and so varied among them. Some of them are holding flowers, some of them are holding keys. It looks like this in the back with some starry, shiny elements, the graveyard in front of the house, more birds squawking. You can see more of their gorgeous coloring here. And it is, like I mentioned, a completely clear dust jacket, which I think is so fun and so beautiful. I did not actually get this in a subscription box. I purposely bought it from a Lumacrate when it went on sale later, which FYI, if there's ever a special edition that a book box does and you love it, if it doesn't sell out right away, they usually will do some kind of like general sale where the public can access it later on for a one-time purchase. This is what the naked hardcover looks like. It goes all the way around, which I absolutely adore. It is so, 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 so pretty. These are the edges with more of the starlings. I'm gonna assume they're starlings. And again. The bottoms are just like black, but the edges are here with that more rich color. All of the details and the birds really just impress me. This is what the end paper looks like. I love how all of these special editions have such beautiful end papers with the character. Just true artistic talent is so good here. And the end papers in the back are exactly the same, which I am just realizing now. So that is what that looks like. I did also purchase this. This is not a special edition. This was the first run print, so anyone could buy this. You may still find copies of this in stores. I will tell you, of all of my sprayed edges, this is perhaps one of the most complex ones that I've ever seen. It is so beautiful. This is a story of like five assassins who are trying to kill a king. It goes on sale quite often, so if it is still available and you like these sprayed edges, like, it's not a special edition. It's just first run. Printed edges. It's printed by the same publishing company that did Fourth Wing. What I will tell you is that I've heard very mixed things about this and very questionable things about the writing. However, I still think I'm going to enjoy this. I know that there are queer elements to it. I love how the blades themselves are very shiny on the cover. The swords, very shiny. And that's really all I have to say. What I will tell you is that it does not only have the very pretty sprayed edges, it also of course has the custom end papers. So here we are, and same thing but in the reverse. And that's it. That's what the naked cover looks like. Just truly a lot of detail went into printing this book. This is not actually foiling, like, it's embossed, it has texture, it is raised, and she's very pretty. And my final one is one of the very first books that I ever got from Fairy Loot. It is so beautiful, but I will tell you, she is quite flawed because it was not bound very well. If you can see, it has that big ass fucking gap in the binding, which makes it a book that's very difficult to read. This is Daughter of the Moon Goddess. First of all, the cover, the dust jacket, gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Love when it goes all the way around, all of the cherry blossoms. It is just so goddamn pretty. The edges blew me away the first time I saw them. The detail, the beauty, how the flower actually looks like it's glowing in moonlight. Love it. Like a lot of Fairy Loot books, it doesn't go all the way around. It's just the edges that are stenciled, and then the bottom and top are just a solid color. I will show you the dust jacket as always. None of these have reversible dust jackets, so... very, very, very pretty. Such a beautiful scene. Such gorgeous artwork. Again, I'm always blown away by the talent of the artists who collaborate on these book boxes to make this art. Like, tell me that is not the most beautiful scene you've ever seen. Really bringing the characters to life. And then this is what the naked book looks like. I don't like handling this book too often just because I feel like the pages are gonna fall out. It is just so poorly binded, and that is truly a flaw of this book. But it's gorgeous. It's stunning. I even love the stark white. It makes so much sense because it's the moon, Daughter of the Moon Goddess. And I just love it. So that does bring us to the end of this video. As always, thank you so much for watching, Bestie. I hope that you enjoyed it. And thank you for indulging me and just letting me show you all of my pretty books. I will see you in my next video. Bye.